right now. If you look up, Jupiter and Saturn, the two largest planets in our solar system, are coming closer together than they've been since the Middle Ages. We're talking 1226. Fox 5's Jacqueline Sarkeesian spoke with some local astronomers about what's being called a Christmas star. Jacqueline.
Kathleen, good evening. This really was a once-in-a-lifetime experience because the last time this happened was 800 years ago. Thanks to one guy who lives nearby in this area, he busted out his high-tech telescopes, giving my photographer and I the chance to witness and see this great conjunction. Kathleen, I'm not going to lie, it was pretty amazing.
Do you see Saturn with the rings around it?
Yep.
And you see the bright one with the four little moons next to it?
Yeah.
That's Jupiter.
Cool. It's not just cool, but extremely rare as well. On the night of winter solstice, Jupiter and Saturn appear so closely aligned in the sky that they will look like one point of light.
Basically, the planets are going around the sun, kind of like cars on a racetrack, and every now and then they just line up with our field of view. However, they don't often come together as close as this.
What astronomer Francis French is talking about is called a conjunction, and it's happening just in time for Christmas, hence the nickname of the Christmas star. Well, it's not actually a star, the two planets will definitely make a bright splash in the night sky.
This is not something that happens for hundreds of years before or afterwards, so this is a really special treat once in our lifetimes that hopefully will cheer us all up.
The last time these two planets got this close was 800 years ago during the Middle Ages. If you're a stargazer like Carter Haas, who's a member of the San Diego Astronomy Association, you're going to pull out the best of the best to watch the spectacle.
The astronomers recorded it by writing down on paper and seeing how close the two dots were on paper. Now we have modern instruments like these that can go look and just gaze at these beautiful planets.
Even though the planets may seem close, they're still hundreds of millions of miles apart. But thanks to Haas's telescopes, several of his neighbors were able to see the great conjunction.
That was awesome. You can actually see some of the rings, and you can see the little moons around it. That's pretty neat.
It's cool that we get to see it just in our neighborhood too, that we can have the clear skies and be able to see it so nicely.
It was really cool.
And that little guy, Andrew, tells me his mom woke him up from a nap to come see the Christmas star, which he was extremely thankful for. You'll be able to see this for the next few nights, but I'm told tonight was the best night because it's the closest the two planets are aligned to each other. If you miss it, well, unfortunately, Kathleen, people will have to wait until 2080. That is the next time you will be able to see this rare cosmic event. Reporting live from Scripps Ranch, Jacqueline Sarkeesian, Fox 5 News.
2080, I'm going to need some stronger glasses by then.